Hello there, and there's good news for football fans today. Jamie, pray tell.
Yes, today the Scottish Government have named the date, Monday the 14th of September, that we could see supporters return to stadia in Scotland. It comes with all the usual caveats about suppressing the virus. But there's test events already being talked about in the lead up to it. Edinburgh Rugby versus Glasgow Warriors matches at Murrayfield at the end of August could be among them. And Scotland football teams match against Israel in the Nations League on the 4th of September as well. The big matter still to be resolved is what the physical distancing will be. The difference between 2 metres and 1 metre will make a huge difference in how many fans can get into these stadia.
Ahead of the big kickoff, a huge blow for Aberdeen. Chris, bad news.
Oh, absolutely terrible news for Aberdeen Rahman. Sam Cosgrove is their talisman. 23 goals last season. That's out of the team potentially for 3 months. It could be as late as November before he's back in a red shirt. Aberdeen, they could get somebody in, but will they be match fit to take the field against Rangers on Saturday? I'd very much doubt that. It may be that they have to go with what they have already in the building. That could mean Bruce Anderson, who's already scored against Rangers, stepping up to fill Big Sam's boots.
He'll be out possibly 8 to 10 weeks. I know it's been reported a bit longer than that, but we don't anticipate that. But it's still long enough, especially in the eve of the new season.
Well, today I attended St Mirren's media conference a week after the club was in lockdown after 7 coaching staff tested positive for coronavirus. 6 of those proved to be false positives. Manager Jim Goodwin was one of them.
You know, first and foremost, you're concerned about your family. And then, of course, I'm concerned about my colleagues because I'm thinking the worst. It is a stressful time. I'd be lying if I said you're not worried every week when you do the test on the Monday and the Thursday and you're waiting for those results to come back. I think it's going to occur regularly. I think, you know, where sometimes the samples aren't quite as accurate as what maybe they should be.
Well, as players prepare to take a knee this weekend, Kilmarnock manager Alex Dyer says it's encouraging to see people recognise there is a problem with racism which needs stamped out.
It's not just about black lives, you know, it just means that black lives matters too. It's not to say that no one else's life don't matter, because of course it does. You know, everyone's been put on this earth for a reason and to respect each other. And that's all you want in life.
And finally, after signing for Celtic to become the most expensive keeper in Scottish football history, Vasilios Barkas is all too aware of the expectations as Celtic go for 10 in a row.
I don't feel pressure about this. Okay, it's normal now, the price all the time go up and up, so it's something normal. I'm an international player, so I think it's normal.